So hello everyone, a warm welcome to all of you. Good afternoon. I am Dr. Diksha. I am a spiritual healer, occupational therapist, hypnotherapist and life coach. And the topic for today, as we can see, is how to increase abundance naturally by following simple daily rituals. So we all want abundance in our lives, right? So, and we want this session to be interactive. So it's not just that I'm going to talk and all of you are just going to listen. So tell me, when I say the word abundance, when you first hear me say the word abundance, what is the first thing, idea, image, words that pop up in your mind? Okay, so what is the first thing that comes to your mind? Okay. Okay. Okay, okay, okay. You, sir?
Lavish,
all right. Anyone else?
Lots of money.
Lots of money. Okay, anyone else? No? Okay. So the thing with abundance is, any time we hear the word abundance, we equate it with money, right? We think it is about being rich in money. For some people, they think it is about being rich in relationships. It's about being rich in prosperity.
In a plenty.
But thing with abundance is that abundance is like a vast infinite ocean. So when we talk about that abundance is only, you know, money. So it's like there's this whole ocean out there and we are looking at a small creek and we are saying, ye jo creek hai na, this is abundance. Then probably we think that no, abundance has to be something greater. So we look at a river and we say, okay, so this river, so abundance is probably love. So yeah, abundance is basically love. Abundance is this river. But often what we forget is abundance is more than something which is out there. Okay? It is more than money. It is more than relationships. It is more than being rich in joy, being rich in love. And it is a state of mind. It is basically, you can say, an emotion. It's a field where anything and everything is possible. And once we are able to tap into this state of mind, into this energy of what is abundance, we would be able to change our own reality. But before we would like do this, before we would tap into abundance, before we would like want to welcome abundance, it's important that we understand and feel what is abundance firsthand. Yeah, please come. So, yes, please be seated. Yeah. So now that we're talking about abundance, right? So now I would like you all to close your eyes. Okay? Make yourself very, very comfortable. All right? Take a few deep breaths. Relax yourself completely. The same goes for people who are watching us on YouTube. Close your eyes, relax yourself. Take a few deep breaths and ask yourself to relax, relax, relax completely now. And as you ask yourself to relax completely, look above you. Look above you and mentally visualize, imagine, feel, see, pretend or see the vast sky which is right above this roof. Visualize the beautiful white clouds, the calm, beautiful waves of winds slowly brushing off your face, and how vast, how limitless the sky is. The light of the sun falling gently on your skin, exactly the amount as much as you like it, and feel it completely. Feel the vastness, how limitless the sky is, how infinite it is. And once you feel you have tapped into this feeling completely, soak it in and then slowly close your eyes, coming back to the present. When you feel ready, yeah? Okay. Okay. So we'll wait for those who are still yet to open their eyes. Excellent. Okay. Okay. So now that everyone has opened their eyes, what is it that you sensed when you closed your eyes and you tried to tap into the vastness, the spirit of the sky? What could you sense?
I just walked inside.
Okay. It's all right. Anyone else? Okay. Anyone else?
Not sure.
Okay. Okay. So now the thing that I was trying to tell you is, we could at least sense some sort of vastness, some sort of expansion, right? Like that of the sky, right? And this is what abundance is in reality. Something that we always see out there in the universe. How vast the universe is, how infinite the universe is, how abundant the universe is. And we are made by the universe, right? So of course, if something out there is so vast and abundant, in the same way, if we are made up of it, we also have that same vastness, same sense of limitlessness, right? So now that we know this, what we are going to do, welcome. Please be seated. So what we are going to do now is, we are going to look at simple daily rituals that we can follow every day. Please be seated. In order to ensure that we always have this abundant supply of energy, this sense of abundance, alright? So the first thing that we're supposed to do is something that I call as shower meditation. So I'm sure all of you have a shower in the morning. Yes? No? Yes? Right. So there's no way you can tell me ki ye to possible nahi hai, I can't do this or anything like that, okay? So the thing is that a lot of self-help books, self-help gurus, they keep telling us it's very important to be positive. Positive rao, positive rao. Matlab rona hai, tu bhi like be positive. But how is it possible if there's a cup and it's completely filled with negativity, with dirty water? Aap wo nikaloge hi nahi, so how would you get positivity? How would you put in clean water, right? So this is what shower meditation is going to help us do. So every day, as you have a shower or a bath and you pour water on you over your body, imagine that as you're pouring water over your body, as you're getting rid of all the dirt, you are also releasing and getting rid of any self-limiting beliefs, any negativity, any negative emotions that are there inside your body of your own self, or that you have absorbed from someone else. And it is getting released completely and going down the drain. Just like all the dirt and the dead cells that were there on your body. And initially, in a day or two, you won't see any sort of difference. But as you keep doing it consistently, you will feel rejuvenated, fresh, not just from the outside, but from the inside. Energetically. Yeah, your energy profile is what I'm talking about here. Okay, so get this. Any doubts over here? Yeah? Excellent. Now the next thing that you can do is something that I call blessed love it. Okay? So let's say that we want abundance with regards to money. Alright? We want abundance with regards to money. Now universe understands the language of symbols. Aap bas bologe mujhe money chahiye, toh it won't be so focused what you're doing. Manifestation. So what you can do is, what is symbolic of financial abundance? What is the symbol for financial abundance? Dollar. Yeah. And currency. Okay. So we can choose a 500 rupee currency note. Keep it in front of your eyes. And look at it and think of someone that you really love. Project that love onto the money and say, money, I really love you. Money, I really love you. Say it till the time like you really feel a sense of conviction as you're doing it. and you don't feel any sense of resistance. So initially, as you do it for the first time, it might happen that आपको लगेगा क्या कर रहा हूँ मैं, ऐसे मानी को देख के कौन I love you बोलता है. But I think it's better to go through certain forms of inhibitions and self-judgment instead of closing your doors towards abundance. तो पहले लगेगा कि what am I doing? But as and when you start seeing results and you start seeing that it's really working for you, so then you would feel, yeah, let me continue doing this, okay? And this thing you can do as many times as you want throughout your day. Next is the practice of Ho'oponopono. I think a lot of you must have heard about it. There are a lot of talks about Ho'oponopono also. So for those who do not know, Ho'oponopono is an ancient shamanic technique, okay? And it is basically a cleansing tool by which you change your programming, your subconscious programming about anything and everything. It can be about money, it can be about your health, it can be about relationships, it can be about love, self-love, anything. So let's say again, let's come to money, that I want to have abundance with regards to money. So then again, I think about money and I say these four words and I mean it as I say it, okay? I say, thinking about money, I'm sorry, please forgive me, I love you, thank you. Do it every day and do it at least for 20 minutes. You will definitely start seeing a shift in your abundant reality, in your financial reality, in your relationship reality, whichever place that you're seeking abundance for. Alright? Okay? So these again, Ho'oponopono, like love and bless it, you can do it as many times as you want in a day. Okay? Next thing that you can do at night, like I would recommend that you guys do it at night, is gratitude. So gratitude is basically saying a thank you and meaning it, appreciating what you have in your life. So let's say I want abundance of love in my relationship. I feel it's lacking, okay? But now we know that it's lacking because I am I am functioning from a scarcity mentality, not from an abundant mentality. Now we know that abundance is a state of mind, right? So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to sit at night and I'm going to list down 10 things in my relationship where I could see some sort of love. That's what I want, right? I want abundance of love in my relationship. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to think of 10 things in the entire day where I could see love. Okay? So let's say that my partner wished me a good morning. Okay? So that is one gesture of love. That is one way that I could feel that love. Now, this is for relationships. Second would be for money. If I want more money in my life, so how I would be using gratitude for this? So I would think of the ways in the entire day where I have spent money. It can be even 1 rupee, 5 rupees, whatever, but it made me really happy. So for example, I think all of us like ice creams. Yeah, ice creams make us happy. How did you get that ice cream? Through money, right? So you would put that in your gratitude journal, or you would say it mentally that today I'm grateful that I could buy an ice cream with the money that I had. Alright? Okay? So this makes sense, at least 10 things every day. Okay? After this, these are the daily rituals that need to be followed every day in order to increase abundance in your life. Now, what I would be telling you is about specific things that you can do in order to increase abundance, especially in your finances. Alright? So the first thing is that abundance is an energy of flow. Okay? Samajh mein aa raha hai everyone with me? Yeah? So abundance is an energy of flow. So agar I want ki it should be in a state of flow, the money that I have, it should also be in a state of flow. So let's say I have 3 bank accounts. In one bank account, I have money which has been forever in that bank account. Okay? So basically it is giving off this vibe, this vibration of stuck energy. वहाँ पे रुका हुआ है, there is no flow of money, right? So now what will happen is कि in my physical reality, I would see money being stuck. I'm not getting my payments, business के जो payments है वो नहीं आ रहे हैं, I'm not getting my salary on time, or something like मैंने किसी को कभी तो दिया था, that is not being returned. So if this is what you're going through currently, what you can do is, if you have multiple bank accounts, you can transfer the money from one account to the other. Let that flow be there. And then you would also see a shift in your physical reality of financial abundance. Makes sense? Yeah? Next thing which is there is the money that you make. Let it be from a place where you are happy. So let's say I do a 9-to-5 job. I earn a lot of money, but I'm not happy about it. So what happens is ki many a times we think things like ki ha abhi to main bahut kama lunga, then after I grow old then I get to enjoy that wealth. But what happens is later, because we had been in so much of stress, we are not able to enjoy that wealth. We fall ill, we have other responsibilities. And what's the use of this financial abundance if you're not able to enjoy it, right? So better what you can do is the work that you do, see it that you enjoy it, so that you're not giving off these ideas about money, that money is a struggle, money is difficult, money is a lot of hard work. Make it something enjoyable for yourself. If you're doing a job and you can't leave it right now, so see to it that you take these mini breaks for yourself. You know, you go out, you create an environment where you deal with people who are more positive, who don't probably involve in office politics and all of those things. So you come from a abundant, from a love space, okay? So the money that you're making would also reflect the same vibration. This is the second thing. Third thing what you can do, especially for financial abundance, is that talk good things about money. So often if you suddenly make a lot of profit in your business, we often say things like, "Arey, ye kaise ho gaya? Maine to aise socha bhi nahi tha." Or, "I don't really deserve it." Or if someone else makes a lot of money, we say things like, "Ki usne to kuch to black money hoga, usne to kuch to cheating se kiya hoga." So what happens is when we talk these things about money, about our own money or someone else's money, we give off negative vibrations. Okay? And this itself stops the flow of money. It's as simple as this. If there's a person in your workplace aur aap uske samne jaake uske bare mein galat cheeze bolte rehte ho, is that person going to like you? Is that person going to come and talk to you? No. So it's the same thing about money. If you talk bad things about money, so money won't feel like coming to you. So it's the same equation. Yeah, simple. Yes. Okay. Then next thing that I would like to speak about the law of abundance is, law of abundance is nothing which is again out there. It is just basically about your connection to your source energy. Okay? And we have a lot of ideas about abundance, about love. And here when I say abundance, I mean all kinds of abundance. I mean richness in financial wealth, health, love, relationships, all of that. So we often have this idea in our mind that in order to get something in life, we have to earn it. Right? This is our idea of abundance, about love. But आप देखोगे, if you go out there in nature, so sun never tells you कि no, you do like, you go to the gym today, you take care of your parents, only then I'll shine on you. ऐसे कभी होता है? Or the sun says something like कि you're too poor, so I won't shine on you today. Does it say something like this? No. The light of the sun is unconditional. So we humans have made it into ki if I want something, I have to do something about it, I have to run behind it. Aur wo ek hi cheez hai, and wo jo ek person jayega, usko hi ye milega. So it's nothing like this. Just like in the universe, in nature, there is always bounty, abundance and plenty. In the same way, it's with you. And there's no one else who's going to go out there and give it to you. It's your own self. So when you are in complete alignment to this abundant source of energy, that is when there would be a shift in your reality. All right. And how would we shift this reality? By following the simple daily rituals that I talked about today. So I hope this talk was helpful for all of you. Yeah. And do practice these rituals. And as you can see, I put on my number, my email address and YouTube name over here. So you can email me, you can ask me your doubts and let me know how you like the talk. All right. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.